Well, when the border to Canada fully reopens someday, Western New York Congressman Brian Higgins says that we need to be poised to take advantage.
And today he said he believes that a key to all of that would be to expand passenger rail service between Buffalo, Niagara Falls, and Toronto. Channel 2's Dave McKinley has more.
When cross-border train travel was allowed, there was only one train out of Niagara Falls to Toronto per day. It left at a time inconvenient for most, took nearly four times as long to reach its destination than it would have by car, and was more expensive.
The Biden administration has identified the Buffalo, Niagara Falls, Toronto route as a priority as it relates to enhanced travel. So all of those inconveniences that you identify accurately would be addressed in that kind of plan.
A plan that would include addressing a two-hour delay for a train just to clear customs and improvements to the rails in southern Ontario.
But for most of these improvements to occur, Washington and Congressman Higgins can want it all they want, but really it is up to the Canadian government.
That would require a substantial investment of infrastructure in Canada.
And he admits some convincing.
It has to work for both of us, but when we extol the virtues under normal times about our proximity to Ontario and, you know, over 14 million people to our economy, there is a mutual benefit to the Ontario economy from Western New Yorkers going over there.
It would also take some convincing of the traveling public. A Department of Transportation study notes Amtrak is only used by 0.5% of all travelers within its upstate corridor. And at the $44 million Niagara Falls train station in particular, the total number of passengers getting on and off the three trains that arrived and departed here on an average day was only about 90, a number that has been reduced by more than half since the pandemic began. Dave McKinley, Channel 2 News.